in basketball, you have your GOATs. You know, you got Michael Jordan, you're going to have LeBron, you're going to have Kobe, you're going to have KD, and then you got guys like me who are from the underground, who are the underappreciated, the underdogs. So I feel like I'm the underground GOAT.
Welcome to my dad's house, aka LouWillVille.
When I turned 21, I bought this crib, got it for a steal, and this became the new hangout. You know, it was bigger, it was better, and I'm attached to the house. You know, it's an entity within itself. And so, like, I haven't moved. So I bought this house, you know, over a decade ago, and I've changed it so many different times to fit different places in my life that I was in. Rick Ross has been here. French Montana has been here. Meek Mill basically lives here. He's one of my best friends. Meek and our relationship goes way past basketball and rap. I met Meek early on when I was in Philadelphia. We just hit it off, we clicked. He was trying to get his career off the ground. I was trying to establish myself. I mean, our personalities, it just made sense. And we just developed a relationship, man, over 12, 13 years ago, man. So we super tight. House Party music video was shot here. They messed my house up pretty good that day, but you know, the label paid for it. That was a cool experience. But the video and the song was inspired by an actual house party that we had here. I make music. By the time I retire, I'll probably miss my window to be a full-time artist. But one of the goals that I do have, I do want to make somebody a star from the ground up under our umbrella. That'll be like, I think that'll be bigger than anything I could do for myself.
You have an impersonation of your dad on the court?
Huh?
So you have an impersonation of your dad on the court? How does he play?
I don't know.
I enjoy the position that I'm in with my kids. I have an 8 and a 5-year-old. They're growing into their own people. They're growing into their personalities. I really enjoy seeing them grow every day. I grow every day as a person. The music grows. Everything around me is just kind of building up. So I enjoy a day at a time.
Perfect.
He's like a big brother to me. And even before that, he was just, he was an idol of mine. I had never met him before, but I had patterned my game after him. My tattoos was influenced by him. Just what he represented to the game and who he was. When I first came into the league, I played fast, I played upbeat, took bad shots. And then like year 5, I began to understand the game. Now year 15, I play slow. It's methodical. I'm gonna get to my spots. You're not gonna stop it. So I've evolved over the years, but it's always been in the course of being a scorer. I'm one of those people, I'm not really talked about, but everybody knows that I'm there. No matter how many all-stars on the floor, I'm gonna be one of those guys that's gonna be talked about as well. So I look at it as like an assassin. Like, you know, it's a lot of guys that you gotta deal with on the front line, but you know somewhere is somebody that we gotta look out for, and I'm that person. I got traded to the Clippers. I was in China, and it was like 3 o'clock in the morning in China, and got a call from my agent. It's like, yo, Houston is gonna move you to the Clippers. And I cried like a baby. You know, and I cried like a baby because you just feel underappreciated. You know what I mean? Like, I had a group chat with the guys that I played in Toronto with, Kyle, Amir, Chuck Hayes, and DeMar. I told him, I said, you know what, man? I think I'm gonna play this last year of my career, last year of my contract, and I'm gonna call it quits. And just to be frank, I told those guys, so this year in LA, I'm gonna go out with a clear mind and go do what the fuck I wanna do, and I'm gonna go home. You know what I mean? And so that was my mindset. So in my mind, I was planning my own farewell tour without telling anybody. And Doc set me down and he was just like, yo, your energy is off. He's like, it feels like you don't want to be here. And I told him, I said, I don't. He was like, well, why not? I was like, this is my sixth time. This is my third team in 6 months. Like, this is crazy to me. And he said, well, I don't know what those other teams are thinking, but you can get comfortable here. This is going to be home. Just embracing six man, just it's like, it is what it is. You know what I mean? At some point you realize like, this is year number so-and-so of me coming off the bench. Like, this is who I am. My position was kind of weird because I'm coming off the bench, but I'm doing everything career-wise that you would expect from, you know, all-star guys. You know, so it was like, why not embrace it? You know, why not? It's a different lane. And I think these past couple of seasons, just the love and respect that I get from guys that I play against, you know, the things that they say about me, the things that guys I compete against, how they feel about me, that's satisfactory enough for me. I'm at the point where I'm comfortable in my skin with who I am in my career. I'm comfortable with what I've accomplished up to date. You know, obviously it always can be more, but I don't go out there really thinking about what else can I do at this point. I go out, give it my all, and I live with the results.